Hi everyone, I am Priyanka Jain. I am a verified educator at the Unacademy Plus platform, and there is a big news for all of you. We are starting a course, a theory course for the inorganic chemistry for the CSIR NET as well as GATE exams. For both the exams, this will be, and here we will cover unit first, unit second, and unit third. In unit first, you will see whole the periodic trends, whole the properties. In unit second, you will see whole about the bonding in the homo and heteronuclear molecules. Whatever you need, you will see here with the questions, okay? And in the third unit, you will see acid and bases and non-aqueous solvents. All the things will be cleared here, and there will also be doubt session. And this course will be in Hindi, and the course is starting from 11th of October, okay? So if you want to see this course, what you have to do? You have to subscribe the Unacademy platform, and then you have to click on my code. My code is Priyanka Jain 10, PRIYANKAJAIN 10, okay? If you are clicking on my code, you will get a 10% discount on the subscription. And here is a special thing for you. In the special classes, you have an opportunity to raise the hands. By raising your hand, you can clear your doubts in the live session. So subscribe the Unacademy. Hi students, welcome in chemistry classes. I am Priyanka Jain, and we are studying stereochemistry. In our last lecture, we have studied about the conformations of butane and ethane. Okay, now we have to study the conformations of cyclohexane. Before we start the conformations of cyclohexane, we should know about some terms, about some type of strains actually. So these are, first is the torsional strain. What is torsional strain? Actually, it is a type of strain that exists whenever there is a repulsion between bonding pairs of electrons. It means if there are two bonding pairs present. Right? Suppose, understand, if this is one of the CH group, okay, and nearest to this, at a nearer position, here a CH group is present, okay, at the nearest position, then this is the bonding pair of electrons and this is the bonding pair of electron. So there will be a repulsion between these two bonding pairs of electron, okay. So a type of strain generated in such type of molecules, that is called the torsional strain, okay. So higher the torsional strain, lower will be the stability, okay? This thing is clear? Now see, the next type of the strain is the angle strain. What is angle strain? Actually, we know that for the each type of hybridization, there is a particular angle. For example, if we take the sp2 hybridization, the angle should be 120 degree, okay? If we take sp3 hybridization, the angle should be 109 degree and 28 minutes. But whenever there is a deviation from this angle, if there is a deviation, it means if the angle in the molecule is somewhat lesser than or greater than this angle, if it has sp3 hybridization and the angle is somewhat later or greater than it, okay, so in that case there will be a strain generated, that is called the angle strain. Higher the deviation from this angle, higher will be the strain, okay. Next thing is the steric strain. Steric strain is also known as the van der Waal strain. Actually, it generates whenever there is the crowding. It means two larger groups. These are the two larger groups and these are present at very close position to each other. It means if the distance between these two is lesser than the sum of their van der Waal radii, then there will be a steric crowding and due to which there will be strain in the molecule. So such type of strain is called the steric strain. So three types of strain can be present in a molecule. Okay, if we are talking about the cyclohexane, now we comes to our point. Our point is cyclohexane. Actually, what happens? Cyclohexane is a cyclic structure. It was assumed that it is a planar structure. It means this ring is in plane. Okay, all the atoms are in a plane. Okay, so we know that whenever a acyclic compound, this type of acyclic compound, if this is six membered chain, okay, this is being converted to this, then what will happen? The angle will change, okay. So there will be a deviation from the normal angle whenever the cyclic compound is formed. It means there is a deviation from the normal angle. So we can say that in this molecule there should be angle strain present. Okay, in this molecule there should be angle strain, right? So this molecule should be unstable, but actually this molecule is very stable. The cyclohexane is a very stable molecule. So how this happens? For this there was a scientist. This is the name of the scientist, Sexy. They proposed that this molecule is actually, the cyclohexane molecule is non-planar. Okay, this is actually a non-planar molecule. Actually it is somewhat puckered. Okay, so what happens, all the angles are now of tetrahedral. It means all the angles are now of 109 degree and 28 minutes. All the angles are tetrahedral angles. So when there are all angles normal, then there will be no strain in the molecule and molecule will be quite stable. Okay, so in cyclohexane, actually there are two forms. Cyclohexane exists in two forms. One form is called the chair form and another is called the boat form. The chair form is more stable as compared to the boat form. Okay, so we will now study about the chair form and boat form. Okay, so now we can see this is the chair form, this is somewhat chair like and this is the boat form, somewhat boat like. Okay, if we are doing here the numbering, then this will be in this manner 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, right? And similarly here we can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, now we know that here at each carbon atom two hydrogens are attached. Okay, so there are two types of hydrogens. This thing you should learn very strongly. Okay, this you should revise. What is the thing? That there are two types of hydrogens present. One is called the equatorial hydrogen. It means if the hydrogen is present in this manner. See here, this is the hydrogen that is called the equatorial hydrogen. It means that is present in the plane of the molecule. Okay, this is present in the plane, while another hydrogen is present perpendicular to the plane of the molecule. This is called the axial hydrogen. Okay, and this is called the equatorial hydrogen. So at each carbon atom there are two types of hydrogens present. This will be equatorial, this is axial. Okay, similarly here this is axial and this is equatorial. Similarly here this is equatorial and this is axial. Okay, that is in the plane, that will be equatorial. That is above or below the plane, that is called axial. Okay, similarly here this is equatorial and this one will be axial. Okay, clear this thing? Similarly now we can make here, this is the axial hydrogen, this is equatorial. Similarly here you can make, this is equatorial and this is axial. Similarly here this is equatorial and this is axial, and here this one will be axial and this is equatorial, right? And here you can make, this will be axial and this is equatorial, and here this is axial and this is equatorial, right? So in this way you have to make, all the carbon atoms will have two types of hydrogen, one in the plane that is called equatorial and another that is above or below the plane, that is called the axial hydrogen. Okay, now see here, the chair form is more stable as compared to the boat form. Why this happens? There are some reasons behind it. Firstly, you should understand here, in the boat form, if you are looking at the boat form, if you are looking at the C2 and C3, okay, at these two positions, the hydrogens are at the eclipsed position. It means axial axial are nearer and equatorial equatorial are nearer. It means these are eclipsed positions. Similarly, between C5 and C6 positions, at these two positions, the hydrogens are in the eclipsed form. And we know whenever there is the eclipsed form, there is more strain. It means In the case of boat form, there will be a torsional strain. This eclipsed conformation will generate torsional strain. Okay. While if you see the chair form, in chair form, you can see all the hydrogens are in the staggered form. Okay, here all are in the staggered form. So we know that the staggered form has more stability as compared to the eclipsed form. So chair form is more stable. Another factor, see here, in the boat conformation, if you are looking, see, at this one position, at this four position, there are two axial hydrogens are present in this manner. This is called the flagpole. Okay, this is present in the flagpole manner. So there is an interaction between these two hydrogens at the C1 and C4. There is an interaction between the hydrogens. Okay, so such type of interaction is known as flagpole-flagpole interaction. So this is the another reason due to which the boat form is less stable as compared to the chair form. So what we can say? We can say that the chair form is more stable as compared to the boat form. And one thing you should note that the chair form is rigid while the boat form is flexible. Okay. We can convert chair form to the boat form, but there is an energy barrier. If we have to convert chair form to the boat form, energy is required, and this energy barrier is of 10.8 kilocalorie per mole. Okay, so in maximum condition, 99.9% cyclohexane at room temperature exists in the chair form. Okay, one thing more you should remember here, that the boat form is flexible and it can be disordered. Chair form cannot be disordered, but boat form can be disordered, so it can convert to a more energetically stable form, that is called the twisted boat form. So if you make the structure of twisted boat form, this will look like this. Okay, in this manner, or in general, if you are making, this will look like this. This is called the twisted boat form. There is one more form that is called half chair form, but that is of higher energy and that does not exist. Okay. Now we have to see the energy level diagram for the different conformations of the cyclohexane. See here, this will look like this. Okay. Here, this is the chair form. This is most stable, so this will have the least energy. Here same, this is the chair form, then this convert to this half chair form, and you can see here this is having the highest energy, and there is an energy barrier of 45.2 kilojoule per mole. Okay, this is having the highest energy. Then comes this form, this is called the twist boat form. Okay, this is the twist boat form. This is also the twist boat form, and this is twist boat form. And this is having the energy that is equal to 23 kilojoule per mole. Okay, and this one, this is called the boat form. And this is having the energy equal to 30 kilojoule per mole. Right? So you can clearly understand all the things. Okay. Now there is one important topic more, that is called the ring flipping. What is ring flipping? Actually, the chair form exists in two forms. These are mirror image of each other. There are two chair forms that are mirror images of each other. And at the room temperature, there is a quick flipping of the ring. It means one chair form can invert rapidly to the another chair form, that is mirror image of this. So there are questions asked about the ring flipping. Okay, so one thing you should remember here, that whenever there is ring flipping, the equatorial hydrogens will change to axial and axial hydrogens will change to the equatorial. Okay, this is clear. So you can understand this. this basic thing you can understand with the help of the diagram. I am making here the diagram. See here. This is one form, okay, and another form will be mirror image of it. So just you have to make the mirror image of it in this manner. This is looking like its mirror image, okay. So now what you have to do, suppose here this is the axial, okay, I am making the this here, this is the axial, okay, and axial I am making by this blue line, okay. So this is axial, this is axial, and this is axial, and here this will be axial, and here this will be axial, okay, and equatorial I am making by the black. So you can understand this. Okay, now whenever there is a ring flipping, what will happen? This, that is by this black color, this E will change to, this will change to axial, okay. So now what we are doing, we are making this by this black line. This is A, okay, this is A, and this is A. Now you can see here that all the equatorials has been changed to the axials, okay. Similarly here, this is right, and similarly these are the equatorials. Now axial has been changed to equatorials, and equatorials has been changed to the axials, okay. This is the this is called ring flipping, okay. So this is all about the conformations of the cyclohexane. But there is not just end, there is one more important thing, very important thing, is that what happens when there is substitution, whenever we see the monosubstituted or disubstituted cyclohexane, and in that cases the question arises, we have to find out the most stable conformations, most stable isomer, okay. So that we will see in our next video. Thank you.